Freedom come by struggle. Freedom come by struggle. By struggle.
What is the motive behind the OurMumuDonDo movement?
The OurMumuDonDo movement is simply to reawaken the docility of Nigerian youth for them to take charge. Because if they can't see themselves, picture themselves as part of nation building, then they have no future in the country called Nigeria. So it's simply to tell them that it's time they sit up, stop agonizing, start organizing themselves, and to retrieve their stolen future.
Hey, police day, every corner, police day. Police day.
Oga, oga, oga,
oga, where your papers?
Oga,
oga, where your president? Every corner, police day.
You've mentioned time without number that your generation is guilty of putting Nigeria in the place we are in today. How do you intend to rectify that?
By inspiring, motivating and ginging young people to stand up for their rights.
Is it a little too late?
It's never too late. It's never ever too late. And I think the time is now, because of the rot we have on ground, the frustration, the hopelessness, the poverty. There's nowhere else to go except to stand up to these criminals in power.
I mean, they think, say, police now, my friend, but they don't show 2 days ago, say they don't be anybody friend.
Yes.
Say you see only 7 people pairing. Just gather. They talk waiting, they pepper them. When I take spray, gas, they gas them, they send dogs to attack them, they beat them.
Oh, they deny on top.
More than 300.
On top of that, now like life alone, I'm out. This thing, where they happen, you know, go stop. Oh, because all over the world, then they hear them.
Yes.
And by next week, everybody will be out.
I'm telling you.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's either our president resumes
or resigns.
Simple.
Simple. What do we want?
Resume or resign.
What do we want?
Resume or resign.
Our OurMumuDonDo.
Our OurMumuDonDo.
What is the motive behind the resume or resign movement? The president and his associates have said they are not breaching any constitutional laws. Deji, what is the motive behind this movement?
Well, you see, it's both a constitutional and a moral issue. Because when you look at it, Section 144 is very clear that when the president has become incapacitated, like in the present case now, because for 94 days, the president of Nigeria has become incapacitated, he cannot be president. In an ideal country, when the president is sick and becomes incapacitated for a week or 2 weeks, he resigns. It doesn't mean Nigerians to beg him to resign. It doesn't need people to hit the streets to drive home the point. Especially when you consider that this is a president who cried. Who said he wanted, when he wanted to become president, he was crying. He said he had integrity that he should
have. But just for clarity, there is no breach in the Constitution. That same section of the Constitution, Section 144, clearly states that the Federal Executive Council, which is made up of the ministers and the vice president, will have to determine via that panel that they set up. Exactly. So the resolution, the Federal Executive Council will have to set up that panel. And at this point, they're telling you, Lai Mohammed has said that, the Honorable Minister of Transportation has said that, they have full confidence in the president's ability to continue to lead.
The truth of the matter is that because this president in 2010 said that the then president, Yaradwa, you know, who fell sick, should resign. Because he said that he should resign, and if he resigns, he should be impeached.
We know you are working for Buhari, you are working for the government, because they are feeding you. They are giving you money.
Then you who is to oppress us.
But do you believe you speak in cognizance with the major, or I should say the majority of Nigerians, 182 million strong, by asking the president to resign? Because this government has achieved some notable feats in the past 2 years.
Well, I don't know. Maybe we're not living in the same Nigeria as Osasu. Because when you speak like this, we hear people talk on social media. We know Nigerians are grumbling. You know, the only people that will defend this government are people like Lai Mane, Noresta, and a few people, a handful who are benefiting from the government, who are just, you know, feeding fat at the expense of the people. Or people who are, you know, peddling influence, you know, members of the cabal who are peddling influence, you know, by using the absence of the president, you know.
So you believe you speak for a majority of Nigerians?
Obviously, yes, we do.
Wetin we do dem o celebrate. Wetin we do dem o celebrate.
So, as a youth who is benefiting from this fight against corruption, are you in line with what Mr. Deji is saying?
First, I would like to debunk that statement that I am benefiting from this fight, because I am not. And what we have is a cacophony of anti-corruption law. They've been fighting this war since President Buhari came on board. That was the mandate Nigerians gave to him. Unfortunately, we realized that there seemed to be a set of rules for the rich and another for the poor. There seemed to be a set of rules for the cabal and another one for the oppressed. And that is what we've seen play out over time. We've been hearing noises of money received here, money received there. They've recovered millions and billions. But what are they doing with these monies? That is the first question.
I'm tired of living in an environment filled with lies and hatred. No, I refuse to be a tool for promoting political propaganda and enslavement. I've decided to speak and be counted for something. Yes, for something. Because it's time for you to make the same decision for the liberation of our great nation. We're going to take back our country again. Yes, Nigeria needs us. Yes, enough is enough. Because we're going to make Nigeria great again. Yes, that's what I say.
I'm not benefiting from it. I'm sure even Nigerian on the street is not benefiting from it. Because today, we are still suffering. People are hopeless. People are dying.
Maybe people are benefiting. Are you benefiting from it?
Maybe she is, because you know she seems to be in a position that we have.
I see angry faces here.
I'm just a journalist trying to ask objective questions.
I laud you for that, but the truth is, and the reality that we must all come to terms with is that Nigerians are suffering. And the suffering is getting worse by the day. People are jumping off the bridge because there is no hope in sight. And those who are meeting us are not ready to step back. But you know, when you want to arrange a firewood or rearrange it as it were, you start from the top. And that is why we embark on this presumed resign campaign.
We're saying collectively enough is enough.
Yes.
You cannot run a country from outside another country for 94 days. Yes. It's not possible.
Yes. No.
We've turned to the caricature of the world. Don't we have shame anymore? What is going on? What is going on? Okay, so we're gathered here this morning to say enough is enough. It is a simple thing. It is a simple thing. Our mantra is one. Our decision is one. Unequivocally, we are saying that the president will either resign or resume.
Would you agree with Raphael that the level of corruption hasn't been reduced significantly from this government to that past government?
I don't know. I guess we're not in the same country when he has that kind of question. Because every government that comes in is worse than the previous one. Okay? Now, I say this. The knot has had the most short governance since independence. The knot has the most poverty-stricken environment. The North has all the negatives you can ever think about. About 6 weeks ago, we invited some of our state chapters to come. The stories we heard about the poverty in the North is worse than what is happening in the South. Yet, they've been the one that has held to government for a long, long time.
Yes, Nigerian people. Yeah.
Once again.
That this ridiculing has gone on for too long. We cannot remain silent forever.
Yes, I stand with you now. 24/7. Nothing they happen. Father, they here to ginger on.
So it is clear to us that all of this is just a game. It's just a game of the very few people who are manipulating and stagnating all of us, who are benefiting, who are going about the business using Nigeria as their company. And I keep saying, if less than 50 people can hold a whole country to ransom, then the youths should bloody know what they're doing.
What is sickness now? Who is favoring and who is
oppressed? It is even the cabana.
Because the more is the taxpayers' money are going now.
At least 1,000 pounds.
Okay, if he hasn't broken any constitutional law. So if a senator and an ex-governor is receiving two pensions or two salaries, has he broken any law? But does it make sense?
No.
It doesn't make sense now.
You know that fraud will be called.
Now fraud, that
fraud will be called sanaki. You don't collect pension pass anybody for him. The guy collect pension as governor of Parate.
Now,
as the Senate president. If you come up with Senate,
he said he has been
back. He said he has been back.
He's
a bloody liar.
So this is the stupidity in our system.
And the question is for Nigerian youth.
For Nigerian
youth. You have to raise your level of consciousness.
Come on.
You have to understand that this people do not have your interest at heart. You have to start demanding for things that will favor you and your people.
If the constitution is wrong, the way forward is for the people to speak up.
Exactly.
If they don't speak up, it will continue to be wrong and the constitution will keep impoverishing us.
Yes.